You can use an NSG to control traffic to one or more virtual machines, network adapters, or subnets in your virtual network within Azure Stack. An NSG contains access control rules that allow or deny traffic based on traffic direction, protocol, source address and port, and destination address and port. A single network identity group can be associated to multiple network interfaces and subnets, but each network interface or subnet can be associated to only one network security group. In Azure Stack, let's start with the user or tenant portal. There are many ways that you can create an NSG or network security group, and we'll start with the simplest way first of just creating the NSG object. If you notice on the left-hand side of the screen, it does not appear initially. But if I click on More Services and scroll down to Networking, we will see here that there is an option for network security groups. In here, notice that the star is not highlighted. If I simply click this, you notice it adds it to the menu on the left-hand side. So once I've done that, I can then reorder my menu and move these icons wherever I like. So now that we have a simple network security group object, let's start by creating one, and then we will associate it to a NIC or a subnet, and then look at various properties of the network security group. So we'll start by clicking the network security group. And you see I have a couple initially, but we're going to create one from scratch. So I click the Add button. And first of all, let's give it a name. So we could have a whole discussion on naming conventions. That's something very important, particularly for automation and scripting. But for this purpose, we'll keep it very simple and we'll just call it NSG2 since they already have an NSG1. So you can put it in a new resource group or use an existing one. I like to group things according to their object type. So in this case, you see I have two resource groups, one for networks and one for virtual machines to keep them kind of organized. So I'll select networks since I want to associate this with my network objects. And location for now in Azure Stack, we only have one, which can be renamed, but this is the local or single instance. If you have deployed Azure Stack integrated system currently for the middle of calendar year 2018, we just have one region. As we move forward in the future, you will have options to make more regions. So I'll go ahead and click Create. And it's validating it to make sure that I didn't have any errors, I didn't have any duplicate things, and it says deployment in progress here. So I'll go ahead and click Refresh, and there it is. So now I can click on the NSG, and we can take a look at the basic properties. As we mentioned, there's some default rules for inbound security rules or outbound security rules. So we have allow VNet inbound from any port and any protocol by default. We have Azure load balancing access rules, and we have deny all inbound. We also have some outbound security rules that we can look at too as well. In the NSG, we have activity logs. And as we create these, and we can see what operations have happened. So in this case, there is a write network security group operation that was succeeded because I just completed that. We also have access control or identity and access management by default. So when we create NSGs, just like any resource in Azure, we can assign people rights to create these or write them or delete them. And you notice by default, all objects by default will get the subscription owner, which is inherited. But if we wanted to have, say, for example, only the network admins to have access rights to this, we could create an Azure Stack, we could create a custom role-based access control group that may only have contributor rights. But by default, we only get three, owner, contributor, and reader, which these are across the entire subscription, but we could scope it to the network resources. But as we drill down into here, just to show you real quickly, and we go into the network resource provider, you can go further down in here and see these are all the rights that come with that. And as you see right here, there are some default rules associated with the RBAC or role-based access controls for network security group. So what we could do is make a custom RBAC role just to cover these things. And then as you see at the top, we could give the ability to read, write, delete, or do other special actions on that. But in this case, we're not going to change that because it's sufficient the way it is. All right, so let's go back to my network security groups. Back into NSG2. So we looked at access control. We also have the ability to tag these. But we can make one, for example, a common tag I like to have is for environment. So I can give it, so it's a name value pair. So I could give this a value of production and save that. And likewise, I could take all my other resources that I create either in the portal or programmatically and give them also a production environment tag, and we could use that to sort and filter or use it to slice and dice for billing. Within the NSG, we can look at settings for inbound and outbound security rules. So when we click on this, there's a default rules option up here. So if I click it, it hides them. But by default, it did show those rules as we looked at. And likewise, there's outbound. So if I wanted to add something on here, you notice the priorities are very high, so think of that as like a cost in an access control list. If you make something else and you wanted to override that default, you just make it a lower priority, which is a lower cost, and lower cost has higher precedence and it would override those rules. So let's take a look at how that works. So there's different ways you can set this. So this is an inbound security rule, and by default it says any source. But I can also do by IP address specifically. So if I had a particular virtual machine I wanted to talk to this network security group only, or from a load balancer, or I can use a service tag. So service tags are kind of predefined options. So I can say, let's use a source tag for internet, virtual network, or Azure load balancer. And it does all the work for me, and I don't have to figure it out that way. Likewise, we can change source port range, and you can do these with comma separated values for different things. So for example, if I had a SQL Server and I wanted to have 1433 and 1434, I just put a comma between them, or I could put a range with a hyphen in there as well. And then I can look at the destination. So if this was a three-tiered application and this was the front end and I wanted the destination to go to the back end, I could have it point to an IP address in the middle tier or the back end tier or another virtual network within that hierarchy. And again, you can get real specific with protocols for any, for TCP or UDP. And then you have two actions, allow or deny based on that. Then give it a name and a description. So that's an example of, and that works the same way for outbound security rules. You'll also see here network interfaces. So in this case, it's kind of interesting. We made an NSG that's not attached to anything. So there are really fundamentally two ways, really three ways that you can add NSGs. So if I didn't create it from scratch, and I'll go back and show this in a minute, I can add an existing NSG or actually create an NSG during VM creation time. But when I do that, it really is not attached to the VM, but it's attached to either the network interface or the subnet. So in the old days, a couple years ago, in Azure, when we had ASM model or Azure Service Manager, you could associate it to a virtual machines. But in ARM model, which is what we're at now, the Azure Resource Manager model, you associate NSGs with the network interface or the subnet. So in this case, I'm going to take a network interface and associate this network interface. So I had to have some network interfaces in the first place, which I did. And you see, so any of these that I have selected or created in advance, I simply click on that, and it's going to associate that network security group with that particular network interface. Now, as a rule of thumb, that's probably not the normal way that I would do these. I would more likely set these at the subnet. So in this case, just to show that we can do this, I'm going to say disassociate. So I'm not deleting the NSG, nor am I deleting the network interface. I'm just breaking the connection between these. Because as a rule of thumb, we'd like to apply NSGs at a subnet. And the reason why is because it's kind of like a cookie cutter approach that we can apply to multiple servers. So if I have three web front end servers and they all have the same rules and requirements, we can simply take that NSG, apply it to the subnet, and then therefore all those virtual machines within that subnet would get the effect of this. So in this case, I can say associate, and it's going to ask me to choose a virtual network. And I have one in my Azure subscription here in Azure Stack, the VNet Hub. And then within that, I actually have multiple subnets. So I can select that. And then I click OK. And now I have associated this NSG with that subnet. Finally, on the properties, this is very typical in all Azure resources. We can see the specific resource ID and where it, so which subscription it's associated with, what resource group. And this is handy when you're doing ARM templates and scripting. We see which resource group it's been placed in, the networks, my subscription name, and the subscription ID. And then finally, just like in Azure Resource Manager with all resources, we can have locks on it. We can actually go up a level to the resource group or the subscription and put a lock. So in this case, I may want to do it for the entire resource here. So I'll say lock name, and I just want to show here. So we'll just say test lock. We have a couple different lock types we can do, a read only or a delete. So I don't want people to delete these, and I can put notes about what this is for. Do not delete, and click OK. All right. And then finally, just to show you, so we've created that, but I also want to show real quickly, if I went to an existing virtual machine, which we have a couple here created. So let's go to one machine here. And as we scroll down into networking, and then within networking, we have the network interface. And again, on here, we can look at it says right here, we do not have any network security groups. So what I can do is go on to either the virtual network subnet or the network interface. And again, kind of a best practice, we want to go to the virtual network subnet. We can click on subnets. And then once I'm on the subnets, I can pick one of these. And here, so going in through the subnet, I can then select an NSG. And note, even though I just created an NSG and applied it somewhere else, I can reuse that on this particular subnet as well. There you have it. That's the way to create network security groups within the Azure portal by creating them all by themselves or associating them to other objects. I hope that helps you out. Thank you.